So I work in the group of Dr. Michael Aziz, and we're working on redox flow batteries, which are liquid batteries geared towards grid scale implementation. And so these are, specifically in our group, these are organic molecules, so safe, non-toxic molecules that can undergo reversible electron transfer processes to work in batteries. And so some of the work that I do is looking at the lifetimes of some of these molecules. So how long can we run a battery with some organic molecule before it fades and our battery dies, in a sense? So right now, more than the majority of our electricity consumption comes from fossil fuel-based resources. And so if renewable energy technologies to get into this grid, you know, make its mark and take over, in a sense, compared to our fossil fuel use, we need to have adequate storage, so batteries in this case, to really back these sources up so that we can still power our homes at night when there's no sun. So right now, this is pumped hydro or maybe lithium batteries, in a sense, but some of these processes, they don't scale when you're talking about how much energy you can have, how much power you can have. These are processes that they're tied together, and in redox flow batteries, this is not the case. So energy output and power output are not tied together, and so we're working on trying to replace some of these older technologies and get massive penetration of the grid-scale energy technology market. So the field that I'm in, organic molecules for flow batteries, is only about 5 years old. So it's a very new field. There's lots of new challenges coming up every day, and it's a very exciting field to be in. And so we're on the cutting edge of what we can do with these batteries and how we can run them. And so every week, you know, I'm learning something new, and you know, we're on the edge. We're on the cutting edge of research here. So that's probably what I enjoy the most.